Yeah. Alright, we're live.
We are gathered here today for an evisceration. I don't like doing these. It adds kind of a negative image to the community, you know? We don't really need that. But in certain situations, certain motherfuckers need to be aired out. And today, we're talking about Rakib Marvelous. You might not know who he is, because, you know...
What the fuck does he do?
Who exactly? Yeah, who is he?
Yeah, what do you do?
What does he do? Can anybody tell me what Rakib does in this room?
Talking about dick all day, basically.
Basically.
On Twitter.
Yeah.
That's basically all he does. But on the low, he's fucking manipulating people.
Exactly.
I didn't even know this shit. I didn't really know it. I knew something. I knew something was wrong.
Yeah.
But I didn't know it was this fucked up. Rakib is using this man. He's fucking been using him.
And
this man, Rakib, owes him how much? How much money does he owe?
$40,000.
$40,000.
His ass from being homeless multiple fucking times.
So we are already 1 minute into the video, and you now know Rakib owes him $40,000. Everything from this point forward,
that's
keep that in mind.
That's the fucking bottom line.
$40,000. Hold that.
Okay?
Now.
Because it's fine, you know? Kobe's helped us all out in this room. Everybody, right?
Everybody.
We already know.
But he's helped Rakib for fucking
extreme
crazy shit.
Extreme amounts.
For extreme amounts. And then fucked him over.
Using his
mental state.
And me
Kobe's
and John,
not good right now.
He's not good.
And Rakib is fucking using him.
Listen, we all go through traumatic breakups. We all know what it feels like. You're not in a healthy state of mind at that point. It's painful. You don't make the best decisions. Sometimes you wonder if the world's against you. How dare you use religion and helping people, generosity, charity, benefit, to manipulate someone into taking their money, using their kindness, and then fucking them up.
And this little fucker as well, he even knew about everything that was going on in my life recently with just my family, how my mom's been recently emotionally.
And he aired that shit out on Twitter. He fucking put that shit on Twitter.
That was personal.
Tweet longer.
Mm-hmm.
He put it on Twitter. For what? He tried to use it against them. How the fuck you use somebody's personal problems against them after they've helped you out so much? How much were you paying in that house?
Dude, I was honestly the reason why that house even became a thing. Because
was it because of him?
Because I had the proof of income. So apparently I didn't even talk to this dude yesterday. So I can't record calls or anything like that because that is illegal. So I didn't want to push past boundaries or anything. But even yesterday, this man called me and he was telling me that, yeah, I'm pretty sure I talked to you yesterday about photoshopping documents because I had no proof of income. You were the only person who had proof of income.
You want to photoshop documents, you little bitch? You want to put niggas name on four signatures, you little bitch?
I just remembered something. This man, Rakib, so Kobe's PayPal, that shit says YouTube on it. When you get paid from it. He was saying that he was using some of that shit to show that he was making some money, and he was passing it off as YouTube paying
him.
What
the fuck?
That's what I'm saying. This
oh
man has,
I just
dropped this shit.
I just dropped this shit on them right now.
You I just remembered that shit. That edible's kicking in, nigga. Holy shit.
You idiot.
No! I don't give a fuck!
Yeah,
what's the problem?
Out.
We're in Vegas!
It's coming
That's
out.
No problem with
it's
it! Just
out.
Like
Rakib,
we're trying to fuck him up like that! See? Let's move on!
Let's get another one! Let's get another time you lied, you little bitch! What about the time that you came up to niggas and this was right after... Oh, you... By the way, I remember that time you asked Sully and Kobe for $1,500 each, so that was...
Yes!
Fucking
Super Mario Maker!
You made him pay $1,500 for Super Mario Maker early! Two days early!
And he never even gave it to me!
No!
Oh, shit!
Oh,
wasn't he at Techno Buffalo and he got that game and he just sold it to you for $3,000? Was that it?
Oh, yes.
Fuck!
Keep living.
Yo, but that man's been helping you out. How come he didn't just hook you up for free?
Exactly.
What the fuck? What kind
and
of shit?
Recently, this is what really made me start to realize because honestly, I've had too many, like I said, issues to deal with besides this shit. And I always gave him the benefit of the doubt. I was really stupid. But recently, he's been trying to throw me under the bus and kick me out of a place that I basically made happen for him so that he wouldn't be fucking homeless. So he was trying to say that he made this place that I basically signed a lease for a year ago, trying to say that it was a mortgage the entire time, trying to make me look stupid in front of so many people. And Duncan Knee Deep was one of the witnesses.
Mm-hmm. You can ask him.
And I just found out recently because he's been trying to exert power. He's been trying to say, you know, smoking marijuana and all that stuff, which I've been using because I've been so stressed. I've had really, really bad anxiety that I've needed it to eat and sleep.
Trust me, it's crazy. This man's not in a good fucking place right now.
You already know one situation it's that happened crazy. Recently when yeah. I didn't have it. I was having so many bad nightmares.
He's having panic attacks and shit. Like, he's fucked up, and Rakib is using that mental state to literally make him his puppet.
To have control over this place, basically say it's his house, and then exert power over multiple people.
This man helped him out with the lease.
And then I just found out yesterday because I called the landlord. I called the landlord a couple days ago to talk to him because none of this shit added up.
Nope.
How can he change a mortgage, or how can he change a lease to a mortgage?
That man said the rent turned into a fucking mortgage. That man said he got an 800 grand mortgage, yet he hasn't paid my boy back yet. What the fuck?
It was a year long mortgage, which just fucking ended.
And how many more houses? How many more houses is that man trying to get?
He was talking, saying that he's gonna try and get
four houses
before even trying to pay me back.
40 grand.
So I called the landlord. I called the landlord on this shit. And he had no idea. He was like, no, this shit's been month to month. It's never been a mortgage. Well,
you
this
can't
man
get four
knew the entire time
documents.
That wasn't a mortgage. I don't know if he actually did or not, but he called the sheriff basically saying, oh yeah, I have a mortgage and all this stuff. And this man's
trying to smoke marijuana. Are you actually doubting whether he did or not? Yeah, of course he didn't fucking call the sheriff. Of course he didn't fucking call the sheriff. He didn't do all the other shit that he did.
Exactly.
Yo, this is fucked up, bro.
The entire time.
Oh, and by the
this
way,
is fucked up. I can't believe this shit, man. What the fuck is this shit?
Let's talk about something else too. It's not even just us in this room right now that are acknowledging that Rakib has lied to us, manipulated us, used us, but a lot of other people that you might be familiar with also agree with that statement. For example, you know, Shofu, Trap God, Young Shofu, you know, all that. Bill Gates, all that, Trap Ketchum.
Trap Ketchum? Oh, shit.
We actually have, I'm getting messed
up. You got it?
He's getting more.
I'm getting more.
More fuel.
Well, he popped an edible too.
Yeah.
I mean, like, we're fucked up. Oh,
yes,
shit.
Yes, yes, indeed.
I'm just letting you know. Plus, that also brings up an important point. When you were fucked up on the stairs and you fucking aired that shit out on Twitter.
He did.
What's the problem with being lit? It's
he
Vegas.
Already,
we're not doing anything
knew.
Wrong.
By the way, this is Shofu. Shofu right here. Look at this. Trap catch him. You see that? Niggas know. Niggas know about Rakib.
We're aware.
Shofu, I know you never fuck with Rakib from day one, nigga. Trust me.
Stay woke. We're all woke.
What the fuck is the problem?
Woke.
So like I was saying, basically recently this man's been trying to say that I don't have any say on this place that I basically made possible for him whatsoever, because he knew the situation that I was in mentally, that I wasn't going to try and dig too much into it, because I gave him the benefit of the doubt for so many things, because these guys constantly told me before, they were like, I really don't believe you should be fucking with this nigga.
No!
And how many people said that shit? How many people said that shit?
Everyone!
So many times that they've been trying to tell me. And you know, I just stood up for him because he always told me about how depressed he was, the multiple times that he was suicidal and all this shit. Like, multiple times I stood up for him. And at the moment that I actually am dealing with something, he tries to throw me under the bus.
Man, fuck. For the longest time, I've just tried to like avoid this fact. Because before, Kobe didn't understand, man. Kobe didn't see that side, but like, you know, eventually shit's gonna blow up in your face.
Yeah, exactly.
You should have known that this was gonna happen.
And even tell him about what happened with how he was trying to get extra money out of me.
Yo, so initially when Rakib asked Kobe for 15K, he was hitting me up about it. He was like, yo, you think it's a good idea? You think Kobe's gonna give me 15K? Yo, what if I lay it out like this? What if I write a contract? He wrote a contract. He said, if you don't pay me by this date, we don't really remember the date. I don't know. It was like, I don't remember what the fuck it was.
Yeah.
Anyway, but the contract, you know, he signed it. He put, if I don't pay you back by this date, prosecute me to the fullest extent of the fucking law.
Rakib, you know damn well that contract is up, nigga.
You know it's real. You know we're not lying about that shit. Why haven't you paid him back and you talking up a big game about three, four houses? What the fuck, bro?
And why is he trying to throw me under the bus?
And why is he throwing me under the bus?
He already knew.
After all the help you gave him.
Because I called him out multiple times. I called him out for him lying to me about someone having PTSD. Because he wanted me to believe that she was so crazy that anything she said completely invalidated.
No.
So, but she was one of the people that he was fucking lying about the most. And then he even, I found out recently too, he constantly says nigger all the time when I'm not around.
Like,
anyone
says black. Racist ass.
He said,
calling people nigger? Huh?
Nigger.
Come call me a nigger. Huh? How about that?
Oh,
listen, we're at Evo. He's here right now. We're not gonna hurt him.
Fuck.
This is not a physical, this is not a violent threat. This is not something where we're gonna cause physical harm. But I'm just saying, we're at Evo. Come call me a nigger, bitch. call me that.
Holy
call me.
Shit.
Please. I want him to.
Well, let me ask
I ain't gonna do shit.
I'm not even against it. I'm a fucking nerd, and I'm saying that.
And right before this video happened, he actually messaged me. He said, is Etika firm on making a video? I've been trying really hard at getting my life back together, man.
Show it. That's a message right there.
Right here. You can't see it. We tried.
No. You're about to see it right now. You see that?
Oh, shit. Okay.
See that?
There you go. You can kind of see it a little bit. So we're not fucking around. That's
Rakeem.
Yeah,
we're telling the truth. That's Rakeem. All
right? And you know exactly the struggle we both went through. So he's trying to guilt trip me because me and him used to talk about this shit a lot. Because he was in a fucked up place. I was in a fucked up place. Yeah. So we were talking about that shit. But he took it a whole different way. That man was talking about some really fucked up shit that he was trying to do to get out of that hole. That man was desperate. And like at the end, he was the one to help him out of that.
Yeah.
That's what, you know, me.
We all said, like, yo, Rakeem, he gives me a funny vibe. I don't know, man.
I told him initially, I was like, 15K, man, that's a lot. I don't know, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, Kobe was like, yeah, I'll do it because he's generous and he actually cares.
You know what you told me? Like, you told me at one point that I feel like God is watching.
That's what he's saying.
God
yeah.
Kobe told me God would want me to help him. And it was like, that broke my heart because it's like, somebody like him, this is my fucking nigga, you know?
Yeah,
this nigga helped me so much, man. I'm telling you, this fucking channel wouldn't be where it is right now. You wouldn't be watching me right now if it wasn't for this nigga, you know?
Fuck.
Like, I'm just being real right now, bro.
It's
like, this nigga
shit.
Helped me, bro. He saved me. Thanks to me. Thanks to this
nigga. This is our nigga right
I'm here.
Yo.
And you know, like, crazy. I fucking love this nigga. And it's like, fucking Rakeem just pulls it out of me, bro. He pulls the fucking worst thing out of me. And I swear to God, bro, I'm not gonna hurt you if I see you at Evo, but I'm gonna let you know that what you did isn't cool, bro.
And it's just like,
this is fucked up, man.
He's literally known, he's known my entire situation.
Fuck,
about my family manipulating me and all the abuse that she's put, well, my mom has put my sisters through, and then even what I went through when I was younger. And then just to find out that he's been the same. He's been providing comfort in those areas, but then throughout these years, he's been doing the exact same thing that they were doing to me.
Fuck.
Trying to act like he was family. And you know, he was someone that I honestly looked up to for a while. That's why I wanted to help him out so much, because I thought
fuck?
He was a good-hearted person as well. But then to find him starting to throw me under the bus recently with so many different things.
He charged him for the bathroom. That man couldn't use the he needed that bathroom right next to his room. That should have been included in the rent.
So
how the fuck you charge a premium for the bathroom?
He was trying to say that bathroom wasn't even mine.
That's fucking crazy. How you charge somebody for a fucking bathroom? I've never heard that shit before. That's fucking crazy.
Yeah, trying to overcharge me and everything.
Damn.
But anyways, it's just, there's so many things that have been just not adding up whatsoever. And I've had witnesses, people saying that they've seen him lie to me straight to my face about this mortgage and how it wasn't a lease at all whatsoever. And then all of a sudden now he's switching it from it was a mortgage the entire time to then, oh yeah, I switched it to a mortgage in February. And then all of a sudden when I call the landlord, this dude's like, he has no fucking idea what he's even talking about whatsoever. He's like, no, this thing has been month to month. The lease literally just ended this last month.
Rakeem didn't think that this man would do it. Cause Kobe's not the type to, you know, be checking and shit and trying to discover something, right? But man, something was really fucking fishy about that mortgage thing. Like, how the fuck are you gonna bring that up
to me about it?
Yeah, exactly. He said that, and we were like, you know, it was at E3 when he told us that shit. It was me,
exactly.
Duncan, Beryl, you, and we were all talking, and he randomly brings up the fucking mortgage, talking
a
big game.
And he's gonna get like four mortgages.
Yeah,
too.
And he was like, yeah, I'm gonna get three more houses. He was like talking up a big game. I know how he gets when he's talking up a big game, because
yeah,
he's like
he
looking down and like doing that shit, you know? Especially in front of Duncan. He was trying to fucking just talk big, because there was no talk of no fucking mortgage before then. It was just because Duncan was right there.
Yeah.
It's one of those things.
He just brags all the time to make himself look bad.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And that's how he built up his career.
Because
he was telling me, what about the resume?
Not just the resume. His Twitter followers, they're all fake.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to bring up.
Wow. Yeah.
You look in the camera. He deleted his Twitter.
He realized this man was going to call him out on all the stuff that I've been talking about, too.
Yo, how'd you get that many followers, man?
Yeah, tell us about those. I'll tell you. Actually, I can tell them.
All right.
He told me.
Let him know.
Time, the best way to increase your social media following on Twitter is to go follow for follow. That way, you gain them, and when you don't want them to look like you're a follow-hungry whore, you unfollow. It makes it easier for you, right?
Fuck.
You fake bitch, that's why you can't even get any likes on your posts.
That's crazy, you're shallow.
Fake bitch.
Fuck. And that's, you know, that's what it is, man. And then he also tried to tell, you know, like, Kobe that He was able to change the lease and get an $800,000 mortgage just because the landlord is a fan of this man and Rakeem.
Yeah, so...
What the fuck kind of story is that?
So he told me in the beginning, too, that I was the reason I got... I was the reason why they got that lease so easily because of my proof of income. Because they didn't have proof of income. And I talked to him yesterday, too, because all of a sudden now, he seemed to all of a sudden realize or remember everything that happened instead of lying to me saying that it was a mortgage the entire time, trying to take advantage of my mental state. So then he's like, no, I talked to you even before. I was like, I don't have proof of income with me and someone else as well. So we had to Photoshop documents to make it seem like we actually had proof of income.
Biggest Photoshop documents, bro?
Basically allegedly committing fraud.
That's crazy.
Committing fraud.
And
committing
fraud. Megan Butcher can, she can kind of testament to that too.
Mm-hmm. She tweeted a lot as well.
She tweeted like this man was trying to conspire to kill his own mother.
She lived.
Murder his mother.
She lived in the same house as everyone else. She lived there.
Yeah, she said he was deceiving. What else did he say? Didn't he say something about
it? Wasn't he trying to actually sexually make moves on her?
He was trying to smash.
When she was with
her boyfriend in the bed.
In the house.
In the fucking same room. What the fuck?
Yeah.
She can attest to that shit.
She was constantly telling us he was constantly telling me that he had like kissed her and all this stuff. All
what
kinds
the
of
fuck?
Different things. Like saying that he was actually like having something with her. And there have been multiple people.
I remember
who
told that shit.
Too. There were multiple people too. Who told
I remember
me
that shit.
That there
he
was
kept talking
that
about that
he
shit.
Said that she was trying to make moves with him as well. And when we actually tell her, she's like, what the fuck? Like, I would never do any shit with this little nigga whatsoever at all.
Fuck.
Ever. Ever. And then he even lied about her having PTSD.
It wasn't the only girl he tried to do that shit to either. What about, Lady Sadie and shit?
You have
that shit on the. I have pictures
on
that shit.
You have pictures.
Yo, I have the tweets. Trust, I have the fucking tweets.
More evidence.
This is not defamation. This shit is all 100% real. This is 100% real.
You got it on you?
And then,
I got it on you.
Let's talk about Glitch X City too, because this needs to go a little bit further. Because Glitch, you posted on Twitter something publicly for everybody to see that Kobe apparently was being abusive and
aggressive
when niggas were getting high when they were smoking.
I wasn't even getting high. That's the thing.
I was there. So what happened was Kobe was sitting there. You know, he was having a good time. He had drink. And she was like, it looked like she was taking a picture of him, right? So he was sitting there and she was standing. And so since Kobe was like, what the fuck? He's like, you taking a picture? So he like tried to grab the phone.
Yeah.
And you know, he was fucked up.
So fast.
So she jerked so fast that, you know, his instant impulse was like, oh shit, you know?
I ended up grabbing her arm instead of the phone to see what was actually going on.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, and but then he let go. And even she even said that in the tweet. It was like, he calmed down right
after. Yeah, she said, he calmed down.
She said it.
Why even tweet? It wasn't a crime.
She was trying to get, because she was saying multiple times that she was uncomfortable or whatever with people like having marijuana and all that stuff. So she was trying to use that against me so that then she would have some leverage or whatever to say that, oh yeah, I'm aggressive or whatever with marijuana, when it wasn't even related to that whatsoever. It was actually me drinking. But still, there was anything that was inappropriate about it whatsoever from what I was told. And even when I talked to her too, I asked her, because Rakeem was trying to say, yeah, you grabbed her ass, like you were trying to like actually be super aggressive. Wait, what? Oh shit, wait, did you find it?
No, I didn't find that. I found something else when he was saying if we put the Sun and Moon ROMs and leak them through Adly.
Oh yeah,
revenue.
Show that shit.
Shit, really? I mean, whatever, yeah, whatever's on here, I don't know.
Rakeem, you're going to, you're getting real kind of like slimy with the shit too, so we got some stuff on you too, Rakeem.
I mean, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, let's take a look at that. So you wanna be a Nintendo brand ambassador still, bro?
Hey, go ahead and read.
Who cares? They're not even.
You wanna leak ROMs? You wanna leak ROMs?
Oh, shit.
Okay.
If they can't see it, go ahead and read off everything.
So you know what? This is where we're gonna approach this from this point forward. I don't want to hear anything about this nigga anymore. Don't want to talk about him. I don't want to see shit about him. If you follow him, unfollow.
Delete
this nigga.
Block him.
If you're a fan of him, be a fan if you want to. You're probably not a fan because all of his fans are fake, but if you are associated with him, block him. I don't want him to exist. It's over for this nigga. Eviscerate.